All right, so in our first lesson, we worked on graphing from slope-intercept form. I'll be honest, slope-intercept form is a really easy form to graph with. You have your slope and your y-intercept. It gives you a starting point and your slope. Point-slope is pretty easy to graph with as well, just as long as we understand how to do it. So that's what we're gonna talk about here. Step one, so here's the graph. We have y minus 3 equals negative 2/3 times x plus 1. This is point-slope form. If you want to graph from point-slope form, what you do is you first identify the point on the line from the equation and plot it. So at the end of the last video, I kind of was leading up to identifying the point from the equation. So do you see how this says x plus 1? The reason why it's a plus 1 is because we had x minus, and then something turned to positive, so we had to have been subtracting a negative 1. So our x value is negative 1. The other thing I just wanted you to take note is that if this looks positive in the equation, when you write the actual ordered pair, it does have the opposite sign of how it appears up here. The y value is this on the end. Here's y minus y1. It looks negative up here. We have to remember it would be positive in our ordered pair. So that's the point of our line, negative 1, 3. We can plot that. So from the origin, you would go to the left 1 and then up 3, 1, 2, 3, and plot that point. Now step 2, we're going to use our slope to get more points on this line. The slope is given to us right there, negative 2/3. I've mentioned in a video, I think it's easier if you throw that negative with the top number, so we can very clearly see our rise is negative. We're always going to run to the right. So with a negative rise from the point we just plotted, you're going to go down 2 and to the right, 1, 2, 3, and plot that point. We're going to fill up our whole graph with these slope points. It is really good practice. Now to backtrack, go back to the first point that you plotted and just do the opposite. Go up 2 to the left 3, up 2 to the left 3. That's the only time you're going to run to the left, is when you're drawing the left side of one of these lines. Okay, we'll do a quick check. Does my line appear to be in a straight line? Those points are looking good. And then also, because the slope is negative, I want to make sure this is a downhill line. And going from the left to the right, I can see that it is a downhill line. So everything is looking good. We can go ahead and draw in our line. Arrows on the end. So step 3, sketch the graph. We did, so we're good.